Here's how you can A/B test YouTube thumbnails with ease to help you create better thumbnails that win the click and earn you more views. Hello, Tube Buddies. A/B testing, or split or bucket testing, is just a method of comparing two images against one another, in this case, YouTube thumbnails, to determine which one would perform better. A/B testing does require our highest level of TubeBuddy, Legend. However, we're going to include a TubeBuddy free trial link in the description, so if you've never had a TubeBuddy trial, you can try TubeBuddy Legend for 30 days. With TubeBuddy A/B testing, we make it easy for you to upload and compare two thumbnails so you can create the best thumbnails possible. A lot of times, a video could show up in search results or even rank number one. But because of a bad performing thumbnail, no one is clicking on it, so it's not getting any views. With A/B testing, you can test and change the thumbnail to see if that can help you get more views. To help your thumbnails get better, let's start an A/B test. Head to TubeBuddy.com/account and select A/B testing here. Or head to YouTube and click on the TubeBuddy drop-down menu. Under website tools, select A/B tests to head to TubeBuddy's A/B testing. If you haven't created an A/B test yet, you'll see your screen like this. However, since we've created A/B tests here at TubeBuddy, you can see them here. You can filter for the ones that are in progress, the tests that are complete, or all the A/B tests you've run thus far. You can see at a glance the CTR percentage of the test you're running. This shows you the score of your original thumbnail and the variation you are testing. You can see the difference in score here. You might also see on the right-hand side a button that says Gather CTR Data. This is just here so we can make sure that our A/B tests data are up to date. Click on it and it will open up the YouTube Studio and gather the data. To create an A/B test, click here. If you're A/B testing an older video, it's important to have that link ready to go. Now, let's create that A/B test. When you're creating your test, you will see your 6 most recent uploads here. You can also search for a video based on your title, or if you copied the link to your older video, like we mentioned earlier, you can paste it in here. If you're unsure on which video needs to have an A/B test done, we give you a link that can help you find low-performing thumbnails here. Once you're happy with your video selection, you can choose which type of A/B test to run. Here you can run a thumbnail-only CTR test. This is just going to focus on improving your CTR and doesn't affect your video ranking or discoverability. CTR stands for click-through rate, and all that means is the likelihood of someone to click on your video when it's displayed to them on their device. For example, if your video shows up 100 times, or gets 100 impressions, and people click on it 7 times, that would give you a click-through rate, or CTR, of 7%. The higher the CTR, the more people are clicking to watch your content when YouTube is showing it to them. However, the other option is a full metadata test. This allows you to change the video's title, description, and/or tags. We only recommend doing this if it's an older video that isn't getting traction. Be careful with this one. This is only for content that is performing badly, and not videos that are doing well. We're just going to do a thumbnail A/B test that doesn't have that much risk. Now that we've selected the thumbnail A/B test, we can choose to set it for a set number of days. The default is set at 14 days, and the reason for this is to allow the video a chance to be presented to viewers in a way that each thumbnail shows up on a Monday, a Tuesday, a Wednesday, etc. However, you can set it to any number of days, or you can run a test until there is enough data to reach statistical significance. Statistical significance just means that you'll know for sure with the data collected which thumbnail is not only better, but is earning you more click-throughs and views. We'll go ahead and run our test for 30 days. Then you can choose when you want the test to start. You can start the test immediately, on the same day at midnight, or you can schedule your test to start later. This could be useful if you want a thumbnail you know your audience would click on, and then you want to change it to be more appealing to a broader audience and see which one is better. We're going to choose to start this test immediately at midnight. Finally, we let you upload the thumbnail you want to test against your current thumbnail. If you haven't created a thumbnail yet, you could use our thumbnail generator here to do so. If you need tips on thumbnails, you can click on this Tips and Tricks button here to see what we recommend for testing. We already have a thumbnail made, so we'll upload it now. Once that's done, just select Start Testing to start your test. You'll now have to wait 4 days for the initial results. We'll now show you some examples of some A/B tests we've already run. so you can see what they look like when they're done. The first test we're going to take a look at is where the new thumbnail beat the original thumbnail. Here you can see that this test is complete, and we have learned that our new variation thumbnail outperformed our old thumbnail by 31%. We found this thumbnail to be statistically significant, or, as we said earlier, essentially guaranteed to be better with the data we've collected. Once the A/B test is complete, TubeBuddy takes no action and allows you, the creator, to make a decision whether to switch to the variation of a thumbnail with a click of a button. Let's break down each of these data points. We explained click-through rate earlier in this video, but if you'd like a reminder, you can click on this tooltip anytime it's shown to get more info on each of these stats. Let's look at impressions to clicks. This shows you how many times YouTube showed your content and how many times people clicked on it. So, we can see that YouTube showed our original thumbnail 1,225 times, but only 84 people clicked through and watched our video. We can also see that YouTube showed our variation thumbnail 1,191 times, and while the amount of times they showed it is less, more people clicked through. So, the number on the left is impressions, and the number on the right is click-throughs. Next is watch time per impression. This is how long each person watched based on them clicking through. You can learn even more detail by clicking the tooltip here. Daily impressions shows you how many times your thumbnail was shown each day. And similarly, daily clicks shows how many times your thumbnail was clicked through to watch your video each day. Then we show you the total views between the two. You can see in our explanation here, although the original gained more views during the course of the test, the variation is actually performing better because it has a higher click-through rate. The only reason that the original got more views is because it happened to get more impressions on YouTube during this time. But people are actually clicking to watch the variation more often when it's displayed. We then show you the difference in average view duration, which matches what we saw earlier, and the total minutes watched of the views you got earlier. Then we show you the daily views each different thumbnail got here. Now, let's take a look at traffic sources. Here, you can see that our variation thumbnail drove more clicks into views in both search and browse. However, the original did do better in suggested. Although, looking here, we made this video for search since people were wondering how to install TubeBuddy. Seeing that the variation thumbnail is getting clicked on more in search, and when people see it on their homepage with browse, is a good thing because that's what we intended this thumbnail to do. Finally, we give you access to engagement rates, but this doesn't really change based on the above metrics. We just show it because users asked to see it. Now let's take a look at a test we're running now, and you can see that the variation in almost all the ways is performing better. You can see this in all the data points we ran through before. However, sometimes, even if you like a thumbnail more, it doesn't mean your audience likes it more. Here's an example of a thumbnail we're testing, but because the first one reiterates the 5, we believe more people are tending to click on it compared to the new one. However, we plan to retest this with me showing a 5 and seeing how that goes. That way we can rule out that possibility. And that's one of the beauties of A/B testing. A/B testing is a great way to find a thumbnail style that works for you and helps your content get clicked on more. We don't want to see you put all this work into SEO for it not to get clicked on because of a bad performing thumbnail. With TubeBuddy A/B testing, you can know which thumbnail is better and drives more clicks to views. If you would like more information about A/B testing, we'll link a support article in the description. We also wanted to say, we are aware that YouTube is working on their own A/B testing feature, and we're actually excited for this. Like with the other TubeBuddy tools, we'll use this information from YouTube to make our product and your results even better. We'll make an update video to this video when YouTube officially releases their A/B testing. Until then, we are working on even more tools to help your thumbnails perform better. So if you'd like to be updated on those tools, subscribe and ring that bell today. Want to see what else you get with TubeBuddy Legend? Check out that playlist on screen now. What do you think about A/B testing? And have you used TubeBuddy's A/B test before? Let us know in those comments down below. I'm Andrew Cam from TubeBuddy. Now go out and run some A/B tests.